Hello everyone, sorry we're a bit late again, but we're trying to be on time. So, hello, this is Ardak here from Zenart Supplies and Beatrice.
Hello.
On the other side. And today we'll try to teach you some calligraphy for journaling and for the art journal as well. So there are some supplies that I brought here, and the journal that I wanted to show you. So it's I added a few pages, these pages that we started last time, and so there are these. This was the weekly spread that we've done last time, and we were using some of these stickers. That was some kind of little trick of how to do it quicker. Then I just adjusted a little bit slightly this kind of monthly spread as well. And here are all these spreads for the for each day, and so, and then another weekly spread. So it's already this week, so I should fill it in. So and as you can see, there are some kind of spaces for adding kind of things here. So just like some little decoration, and you can write it inside with this sort of calligraphic handwriting. So we'll do it after practicing. So, and of course there is also a little kind of piece in our spread for inspirational quote, so for this week. And that's what we're going to do, and we'll do also this little kind of little sort of calligraphy on the daily spread. That's what I prepared a little bit here. So these spreads for each day, plus Saturday and Sunday I combined together, and for the plan for July, because July it starts on Thursday. That's why I didn't want to just like split it. So it was June 28th till 3rd of July. And then it just goes all the days, and we'll do a couple of days together. And then it starts again, this monthly plan of July. And after that will be weekly spread from 4th or 5th of July. So that's the plan. So yeah, you can see 5th of July, 6th of July. So you can do such kind of placeholders with pencil, and it will help you to plan the the spreads before you do it in writing. So it will be much easier for you to understand even how to how many weeks it will fit, and all the rest, and all the practice you can do at the very end. So that's what we were doing before. So we were testing all the materials. And of course, there is also this the last end page. You can also fill it, and we'll fill it together. So, and of course, at the very end, this is the circle of life balance. So, I always start with this circle of life balance, and end it also with the same circle. So you can put the dates for each circle, and you'll know for the next kind of journal where you're starting from, so, or where you ended up. So it's quite interesting just like to check yourself, because this is some sort of mini audit of how you're doing in your life, and what are your next goals should be, in which kind of areas, and these kind of things. So today I want to show you other book. So there are a couple of books. that I was showing before, and today we can use different materials. So we'll be using just normal kind of pens. There's graphic pens, it's liners, and there is also, I think, one brush. Yeah, so this is a brush pen. So they have this kind of tip, and it's sort of felt pen, but it's with this brush kind of tip. And these are normal liners of different thickness. So the thickest one is 1 and up to 0.05. So it's quite tiny, so you can see it. So most probably you'll use something in the middle, and maybe some of the large ones. And the thinnest ones I would use for drawings. So for some kind of hatching and some little kind of drawings that you want to use for decoration. I also wanted to show you this Preciosa set from Zen Art Supplies that we just launched as well. And you can see, you can watch some videos from our previous lives where I was showing how to use for painting with watercolors, but you can also use this particular set for journaling as well, because it's quite decorative. So there are these beautiful colors that are metallic. So, and I think that this kind of metallic colors, they complement quite well the calligraphy and journaling in general. So that's why I wanted just to show you how to use it as well. And there are two brushes that I included, so they can be easily used for calligraphy as well, because this is just a flat brush of very good size for some kind of large blocks of straight kind of lines and thick blocked kind of lettering, and plus this it stays quite well.
And it's a new set.
Yeah, it's a new set, so I was not taking it off. So, and so the brush, it you should turn clockwise. So usually it's probably anti-clockwise to open, but ours opens like this. So just make sure that you try both sides, because I don't know why. When I was checking pre-production set, it was probably a normal one. So, but then we got this little surprise. So it's quite cool as well, I think. So never get upset for such things, because it will just teach you to do things differently. So for using these brushes, I would suggest you to fill it with just with water if you want to use it like a normal barrel brush. Or another way how I use it personally, so it was a tip from my friend Aina, and she had this barrel brush with the ink, and that's really fantastic tip, because you can easily fill it with the any color of the ink that you really love. So I usually use black. Ah, here it is. I show you. Because so this is exactly the same kind of barrel brush from another set that we have. So it's probably from Sirena. So I filled it with black ink. It's water soluble ink, and it's really perfect for having ink with you. So because I don't like to use ink, because it's a bit messy if you just like keep opening and closing it, and just like you don't see where is the level of the ink. But if you use it in the barrel brush, it's really perfect, because it stays almost clean. So just a little bit of squeezed kind of ink, but it's normal. So just try to open it quite without squeezing the barrel itself. So just like this, That's it. So it keeps clean and nice, so you can easily also use this barrel brush with other brushes. So for example, if you make it wet, and you can use it also for something very black, for example, so you don't need to fill anywhere with this ink and then make a mess and then it will dry anyway. So you can just like take it from here as well. So that's my tip. So that's what how I use. You can clean it up, of course, but I don't clean. Maybe I should clean it. So don't forget just to close it properly, so because you don't want to mess up with ink. And yeah.
Every time you mention this tip, we get lots of hearts and likes.
Cool. Yeah, that's great. Yeah, because it's really makes your life easy, and you really. I don't like so much black watercolor to use it, because it's not as black as ink, and you still need to add something else to add the depth, so you need to put lots of layers. But if you use the black ink, it's just like instant black. So that's why I prefer ink to black watercolors. So that's why you'll not see so much black in our watercolors, I would say, yeah. Because I personally use ink, so that's my tip. And we'll also use ink for this live today. So I brought also. I also wanted to show you. So it's a splash guard, but you can also use it as an additional palette. So that's how I use it. So that's another kind of tip. So and we'll use this as well, of course. So now I also have this watercolor brush markers as well. We can also try to use them, but let's start with something. So we'll first use the pencil. So just like a normal pencil, I use this one, so Kohinoor, and because it's retractable and it's very easy for me, rather than cutting it all the time. And now I'm going to use this book by Chiara Pirano. So she wrote this book and ink book about. Nib and ink, sorry, nib and ink. So we're not going to use nib, because we can do it separately, but we're going to use some brushes and pens. So and I like this book, and that's why I bought it. So it has a lot of information for the beginner calligraphers, and I feel like it's quite cool. It's very beautiful, and it can be a great hobby for you, so you can even make money on it. So you can really learn how to do calligraphic kind of handwriting. And so she speaks about all these essential tools with all these nibs. So I have some nibs as well, but frankly speaking, I don't want to use it today, especially on this paper. Maybe I'll test it first, and then I'll tell you how it works, because these nibs, they always scratch the paper, so that's why you need to use much thicker paper, and quite smooth as well. So it should be smooth and thick. That's what I would say, because I was using these calligraphic pens with nibs on invitation kind of card papers, so that's where they work quite well. And they don't work so well on watercolor paper, so don't. Well, you can try it, but for watercolor calligraphy, I would use brushes. So we have these beautiful brushes from Zenart Supplies. You can use a normal round brush with this very sharp edge, so tip, or very pointy and sharp, or the rigger. So Both of these brushes, they are from our Black Tulip series sets. So set, and some others, they're also available in Turner as well. So you should try both, because in Turner there is this slightly softer kind of brushes that are mixed. So it's the same synthetic mixed with some squirrel hair as well. And they're softer, and I feel that it's much easier to control these kind of curves. But if you're doing some, so you really need to learn how to use rigger, because sometimes it can just like spring like too much, you know, so it will not be very kind of soft and fluid curves. So I'll just take some water, and just want to show the tip, the point of the brush. So I just made it a bit wet, and the same for this brush. So just added just a little bit of water. So they're really perfect for calligraphy, and I would suggest, if you have already brushes, I would suggest to try using brushes as well for calligraphy, because they give a slightly different effect, and it's quite beautiful as well. So let's start with the alphabet. So there are some kind of little exercises I can show you very quickly first, just before starting the letters. And it's
Let me just tell you, I'm seeing many new names here, so maybe it's because of the topic, so we have more interested in journaling.
Yeah.
So hello to everyone, don't be shy, because usually we have quite interactive sessions. Ardaka always wants to answer to your questions, so
yeah.
Please feel free to ask anything about products, the topic mm-hmm. itself.
Yeah, if you have other questions as well, or some other topics that you want to suggest, please feel free. So I'll start. We'll do it from right to left, or the other way. You can use your back of your journal just upside down. So this way you'll be just like going towards the middle without any kind of spaces left. So it's your journal, and you can do whatever you want. There are no rules. You should use it as it's convenient for you. So here is my other book, that it's in Russian, but it's quite cute, and there are some of these kind of decorative kind of items that I wanted to do also for you. So just like to show what kind of decorations you can practice at the very back, at the back of your book, and you can use them for decorating your journal. So that's what you can do. You can also cut them out and use them as some kind of little templates, or some kind of, I don't know. So you can cut these pages later or keep them at the very back. So this lettering in Russian as well, and it's really for the journaling. So let's put this on the side.
Thank you. They are saying the great subject. They are interested in the subject. So
that's cool.
Yay!
So I can actually make these pictures in my journal, in my sketchbook. So and then I'll cut it and put it in a pocket, that you have a pocket in every journal, and so you can have all these little kind of I don't know, some kind of stencils. So some people, they use stencils as well for doing journaling. For me, I would prefer to draw, because it's additional way of just practicing drawing every day, so it will be really cool. And here you can see I was just practicing a little bit to make this paper plans, yeah, because it's quite popular,
mm-hmm.
and it's really cute, very, very easy to do. So I want to show you how to make them as well. So let's start, otherwise I talk too much usually. So for example, here there is this mark making. So it's really about the pressure on the nib, but because we're not going to use the ink, I want to show you how to do it also with the, with your brush, or maybe with this brush. So we can just I can just show you with my ink pen. So, or we can also try to do it with this watercolor brush markers as well. So I can use some nice color that I like. It's something like that. Ta-da! I love teal and I love turquoise. So you can guess that I love it. So we can start with this kind of very thin lines. So you just need to try to make the whole line with the same lines. So you should practice, and the more you practice, the more your hands will be. So, and try to make exactly the same kind of space. So the spacing should be the same, and this way you will be practicing this fine motor skills, I would say. Yeah, so that your pressure, the grip and everything. So just like it should be quite it's like what we were doing at school when we were kids. So yeah, so you can do the whole line, or you can do it 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, or whatever you feel preferable. So next one, I immediately tell you that my brushes, especially these tips, they are all damaged by my daughter. So if you see this kind of strange kind of lines, it's just ignore it and try yours. So mine are like this. So you can make maybe longer as well. So just I'll make it longer. And the good thing of the bullet journal is that you have the lines already there, and you can do whatever you want, because so here it's important the angle, the length, the pressure, that it should be quite similar. So try to practice as much as possible these very simple simple things like that. Although it looks quite simple, but it takes a lot of practice to have very steady kind of hand. And next one, let's make it much thicker. So, and here I'm going to press it. So if here I was trying not to press at all, I was trying to use my tip of the nib, so tip of the brush. So here, for example, mine are broken, so it's much more difficult, I would say. Yeah. So try to use the not damaged ones. Don't give it to children. Or just split the colors. So here you can see that it's exactly the same brush, but here it was very bad. so you should really try to practice as much as possible to go to the very similar kind of lines. And here is the, so you should do it to feel how much pressure do you need to apply, what should be your grip, and so on. So
okay. So because they were asking if this is a generic exercise or for a specific letter.
It's a generic exercise for everything. So every letter has this kind of so there are letters that have the straight lines, there are letters that have curves. Everything have curves. And for example, here we're just like doing this curve. I don't like it so much, so I'm not really enjoying this. So I'll take another pen just to show you better. So I have the black one here, and this is completely new, so definitely no one touched it, so you can see that it's really a good one, good tip. So let's, yeah. So here you can see, so from bottom up, and then there will be, or from top down. So you can check how to do it. So the idea is to have thicker inner side and thinner outer sides. So that's why here you shouldn't press too much up, and here you press it. So here don't press. So here it came out quite nicely. Mm-hmm. And before that I was just like really trying to adjust my pressure and trying to adjust to the new nib. So it's very similar to, you know, when you'll be doing it with the nib, with the but this is much easier.
That it really reminds me at high school when we were learning Greek, ancient Greek. So uh-huh. We were doing pages and pages of these letters.
It reminds me of my first year at school because of this kind of little thing. So because it didn't come so easily for me, I'll do another line, but I'll just show you that it's... So here it's much better. Yeah, so I'm not going to do this whole line, but that's the idea. So just to get into this kind of shape. So it's quite thin here, very thick inside. So that's the idea. So you got it, I think. Next one. So we'll do zigzag. Zigzag, it's quite easy, but the zigzag idea is also to have it thin here. Very thick straight line. So you got it, isn't it? So here it's zigzag like this. So straight up, up on diagonal, straight down, up. So something like that. Then there is just a normal zigzag that is up and down, up and down. So you can do exactly the same. So usually in the calligraphy, I'm not a master of calligraphy, I'm just telling you immediately. I'm also learning, since childhood it was my kind of passion as well, the good handwriting, and it was something that I was really practicing myself, just looking at the calligraphy. So I didn't have these beautiful books that explain all the little tips. I was just really observing. If somebody was writing, there were some books or something, I don't remember where did I find it. But there were invitations, I don't remember where I found it, but I was really just like observing, and I was trying to understand what did they do and how did they do it. So it's also quite good exercise probably. So if you like somebody's style, try to observe and try to see where there were very light touches and where there is the kind of pressure, and try to replicate it later. So if you really like exactly some kind of special style, if you don't care, just you can make your own kind of style. It's there are no rules again, as I told you. So just you can make it yourself as well. So here, up and down on diagonal, so you can see that. It's not so thin here, but we'll see. So next one, we'll do just a cursive. So like this. So it's also another kind of element of many letters. And here again, the idea is really just to start thin and go down with pressure. So if you see most of the letters, they have one kind of side, it's always thin, and another is thick, and you should keep it consistent. Then it will look like there is a shadow. So to me, it's the calligraphy and this lettering, it's the way how to imitate this 3D effect. So your letters, they are thin on the side where there is light, and they have shadow on the side, on the opposite side. So it's just like, that's the whole kind of point, I think, because that's why it attracts our eyes, and it looks quite quite beautiful, because it gives this 3D effect. That's why there is a thin and thick, and so you can see that on one side it's thin, then you press it. So to me, it's much easier to do this pressure than to make it quite thin, because you should really just like very lightly touch it. So, and here is the, this is the way how you learn it. So you should try to make as similar as possible. So here you can see that it's similar, here it's slightly off. So next one, it's like U, it's just like so it's thick one, it goes
up a little bit.
Okay.
Because yeah, from now it's not visible. So, okay. Now we're good.
So we should do it thick and up. Pressure and no pressure. Pressure and up. So pressure and up. So in a way, you can also use the same kind of technique of pressure and releasing it also with the brushes, because when you paint with watercolors, it's exactly the same. So you need to make this. You can make a leaf very easily just by just applying a little bit of pressure. So, for example, I'll just show you exactly the same kind of thing. So here, I just want to show you very little pressure up. So it's exactly the same thing, like that's why it's called brush tip, because they try to imitate the properties of the brush. So, and here, if you want, you can also try to use the brush, but of course it will be much more challenging, let's say. So I would just add this, yeah, like this, from the top. So you need a smaller brush than this for making this kind of smaller shapes. If you want to make a bigger one, it will be much easier. So not much easier, but easier. So that's what I meant. So just need some water as well. So you do it. That was on the side. So that's why you need some practice, and just do it. So let's do it again. Yeah, so you see, it's this way, it looks quite similar, yeah. And you also learn how to apply, how much water you need also on your brush, and all these kind of things. So try to use different tools as well, so whatever you're going to use. So next one, it's quite easy. So it's very similar between these two. So you just do kind of, this is much easier, I would say, but you really need to control the length of your um, So something like that.
And okay. I would say, although it's practice, it's also beautiful, the pages that you are creating. So it's always nice to look back at them.
You can also use this kind of little squiggles as your decoration. So it's already a pattern. So it will be really cool because this stuff, for example, it can be turned, I don't know, not like this. Something like that, for example. Can see it quite frequently. Not exactly, so you should practice again, but it's exactly the same thing here, but applied horizontally. And it's already, you can use it as a border. So like this. And just like this. So the pressure with this brush, it's might be, no, what am I doing? I'm doing the wrong thing. So it's just, that's what I need to do. Yeah. And maybe it's just a little bit. So you can always adjust. So if you were doing it straight here, I applied a little of inclination, some little angle. And the idea is really just to get used to this pressure. So how much pressure do you put and what it creates. So the next one. Okay. So Beatrice is telling me how much time I have, because I never checked the time. So this is quite interesting, and it's very much decorative as well. So
it reminds me of something.
It reminds you of Zen Art Supplies. This is quite easy for me to do because this is like a Z, so you can also use this for Z. So this is our Zen Art Supplies. You can see it. Yeah, maybe that's why it was not so difficult for me. But so you can also stylize your letters using this kind of little kind of things as well, so little squiggles. And now again, let's do it. So you can make it a bit more kind of close up. Just a bit closer to each other. So look at this, it's slightly different and it's getting better and better, I think.
Yeah.
So the idea is really to make a variation of the thin and thick strokes. So when you master this thin and thick, it will be even more beautiful. So now let's do some sort of it's like S. So it's much easier to do it with just the same kind of pressure, but try to make it different. Mine, it looks quite similar. So I'm trying to really just to press at the when I go down. Next one, it's like O kind of, so it's like three kind of O's, so it's like squiggles. Mm-hmm. Something like that. So you start from here. So we'll put also the link to this book if you want, or the name of the book. But there are lots of other books, of course, and there's no... Maybe there are some better books as well, but I found that this book is quite good as well. That's why I bought it. So also try to make it quick as well, so so that it will look quite natural, because if you'll be thinking about your movements, and they'll become... So you see this one, I was not lifting so much, and it looks flat, it looks exactly the same. I don't like it so much, so... But if the idea is really to try to lift it so that one line will be much thinner than the other. So, see? You can even... In some areas it might not even touch, but with the nib maybe it will be easier. So, something like that. So with the... Okay. Hooray! We did all the exercises, so you should practice even more of this kind of thing. So I don't want to practice them right now, because for the time, because Beatrice always tells me you do it very slowly, and I know it. So, but now let's try to practice this alphabet, and I really like it. It's quite elegant and very airy. So of course you can you can use a different kind of alphabet style, and it doesn't need to be exactly like this, but it can be slightly different according to your own handwriting, of course. But you can also try, you know. And there are, of course, different kind of calligraphic styles, and something will be much more suitable for you. So there are all different ones, and I would say that I use this and this myself, even without even seeing the it's very funny. So, because my name is Ardak, these names, these letters, I use it all the time, you know, A and K, of course, AK. So I have even more K's than many would think. So, but I'm not associated with any organization with this case, by no means. So, A, let's do A, and I'll make it quite large maybe, so let's do it. Oh wow, they start from the top, I always start from the, they start from here, I always start from the top. So, and... Didn't come exactly, but who cares? let's try to do the way how it's done here. So from the... Oh, not so bad actually, it's much easier. Wow. So you should always check for some... that one should be much longer. So that's this line here, so this A. And here you can see that it's this kind of, well, partially it's this line, partially it's this, so it's, you can see that all these exercises, they're quite useful. So let's do again. Not exactly the angle, but this is my angle really. Looks much better like this. So you can practice, and you can make it more beautiful as well. So now it's a little bit wider. So this one looks much better, but maybe it should go down. So it's really funny, because I keep doing what I usually do, and it's nothing wrong as well. So you can always do the way how you like it more.
Yeah, they think so. You have a beautiful handwriting.
Thank you. I also think so, but yeah. But it's not like this. So I think that my my own kind of way of doing it, it just really prevails, and that's why you shouldn't, so I do it like this. You shouldn't fight it. So if it doesn't come out naturally to do it like that, just do it as you like it. So next A, this is quite easy, so you just do it, and then goes. So it's like, it looks like a little bit of, to me it looks like a Puss in Boots, I don't know, this A, I don't know why, because it looks like this cat with this very, very brave and very inventive, I don't know, that's how I feel about this A. So, let's do it again. So, like this, or I can go even, or like this, even more extravagant. I like it. This is probably my favorite A. If you want, you can do even thicker on the side, just by adding this line or yourself. So additional line, and it becomes even much more cooler. So if you really need it, you can always add just one more kind of stroke on your line, and it really becomes much more beautiful. So because I made this little kind of correction, so I can even mask it with this kind of much thicker brush stroke, and it really becomes more cooler, I think, than when you just like try to cover it with something. It really just like shows like you're not confident in what you're doing, and in calligraphy you really need to be confident with your marks. So it shouldn't be like this, I don't know how to say. They should flow. So most importantly, when you write in calligraphy, check that you're writing correct words. So if it's somebody's name, double check it. If the letters are all corrected, you know it, because otherwise you don't want to, so the whole kind of work will be spoiled. And that's why sometimes some calligraphers, they use this first, especially at the beginning probably, they use the pencil, so just to write everything correctly, just double check that everything is correct, and then they use it already, the proper kind of pen and the ink. So now let's do this very cool one. So can you see it?
Yeah, it was all.
I think this is really the coolest. I don't know how to do it. Let's try. I'll start from the top because I don't know how to do it. And like this. Oh, I think it came out nicely, but not so thin here. But let's do it again. So you can always stop here somewhere and then go something like that. Not so great, but anyway, you can correct it like this maybe. Not my favorite because it's quite difficult for me. So it's something that you can practice more and more, and it will come out quite much better. What's up, Petrich?
Checking because it was paused a couple of times, but it should be charging soon.
So this one, it's much better because you can see that there is a bit more kind of flowy and thinner lines here. So they shouldn't, let's see, you shouldn't shake. The line shouldn't shake. So
yeah.
Just really try to not to stop anywhere. And let's do it again. Looks cool as well. And again. I like it. Okay, let's go for A, and the rest of the letters will not stop so much, so I think you got the idea, and we'll just So here it's quite important just to keep this flowing and to connect to each other. So going. And try to make it similar. So next one, it's quite similar, but with this, I don't know, it's high end, there is a space here. The next one is, and like this. Make it cool. So let's try it again. Quite cute. Or maybe it should go like that from the bottom. Mm-hmm. So just try to observe. I'll not use this anyway, so I'll use this kind of. Mm. So my favorite so far is so something like that and something like that. And this. So probably because it's more kind of natural for me. So now for B, let's do B. Oh wow, I even have clip that is turquoise. Yeah. Okay. it speaks to me. So it's probably the color of the flag of Kazakhstan. That it's really my favorite color. So let's go for B. And B is, it goes. And doesn't look like this B, but let's do it again. Looks better. So really the idea is to get better and better. You'll get there because it's quite important just to quite bad. It looks better, yeah. If you want, you can also try to use just a normal kind of pen at the beginning and then get to this brush pen. So just to master the shape and then to master the pressure. Because if you'll be trying to do both at the very beginning, it will be quite frustrating and might not be the best result maybe, or you'll get you can also use the pencil, of course.
I think this is a good tip.
So, this is the...
Yeah, actually, I was going to ask if they have any specific letter they would like you to try.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. What is
and
it?
We got letter F.
Ah.
We got ready request.
Wow. Look at this. With the help of pencil, it came out much better. So it also could be a nice kind of tip if you're not sure how to do it. Use the it looks quite nice. Let's try. I don't like this one because it looks like D to me. Does it look like D?
A bit.
I would call it D.
I would say it's a B, but maybe not really.
Let's try. This is Beatrice's letter, because she's Beatrice Bianco. she's double B. And let's try this one as well. So maybe we'll make it more like a B. It looks like D. Anyway, so let's try to do it again. So. I don't like it. This to me it looks like D, and mine looks very ugly even more. It looks very bad. So let's do it with a pencil. This looks much better. Okay. So pencil is the magic kind of tool for you, and it should also be much taller.
Yeah.
This looks like B. So let's try to do it again. So take your time and do it as much as many times as you want. Yeah, looks better. So the repetition, it will really make it much better. So another one. Looks not so bad. Maybe you can even do it like that. So, and this B, it's much easier for me. So because you just make this line, which was here, sort of. So this is the line that we usually use it. And again here, so you can see it from here, you do it. Maybe this kind of brush is also not the best for this kind of things, but try different kind of approaches. And what works best for you. Yeah, this is the B. I wouldn't stay too long for the B because I like this one most. And let's do these smaller Bs. Let's try this again. With pencil, it will be much easier because you can also correct while you're doing it. And it should go down here. So that's the correction. So I think it will look better now. It shouldn't go too much. That's okay. Doesn't look so bad. So next, B. So.
These are nice little bees.
Yeah, you should try to start from the bottom, sort of, so it will look much more beautiful. And yeah. It's different from here, but I should do it again. Just a second. So. Yeah. Okay, let's go for the next B. This is quite interesting. Uh-huh. It's quite easy to do it, frankly speaking. It's very very nice, and it might look like H, but if you'll be going down, so just like it's more or less like H, sort of the way how you write it. Yeah, and this B, it looks like some kind of musical.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. So. So it's something like that, but smaller. Yeah, so you do it like that. And then you just start it on the top, like that. Yeah. So you start from the top. So it's more or less like this, but with the with this beautiful kind of piece here. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So let's go ahead. We'll skip all these kind of different variations, and maybe we'll just go for the alphabet and do all the let's do F, different Fs. So yeah, practice makes perfect. That's quite important. F is probably not so difficult because it's very straightforward. And I would even have a separate kind of journal for only for calligraphy, because it will really make your practice more kind of interesting. And it, you'll just have the whole journal for calligraphic kind of exercises, and you'll see your progress. Now let's use this pen. Actually, that's why I also brought it. Fountain pen. So fountain pen. Sorry, fountain pen. It's the nearest pen to the pen. This ink nib kind of pen, because it has the nib and it has the ink. So let's use this one. I think it will be much easier to yeah. So because it has this F. So F. Yeah, because it should be bigger, this part. Let's do it bigger. Yeah. So F. Now, let's. I think it looks nice, but doesn't make this huge difference between the. If you want, you can always add this kind of additional line like this, something like that. Mm-hmm. So this is some kind of for the first letter of your invitation or something. So you can always do this kind of effect. Let's do another version. Let's do another kind of. It's quite cool, I think. Yeah, like this. And here you can see that it's much easier just to mend it, to make it longer, because it's thinner and so. So. You can do all different kind of variations as well. So. No, I don't like it. So let's do it again. Sort of. So if you want to adjust some line, you can just add a little kind of little piece like this. Immediately looks better. Let's use another F. This is quite cool, I think. So.
It looks so difficult, they say.
It's not difficult. You really need to practice these squiggles here, and then it will be much easier to do all these kind of squiggles already in the context of the letters. So it's not so easy for me either, but it's just. So you just need to observe where is the, so it should be here, at the, more or less on the same kind of line, here and this, how far, so if it's on the same, so like this you can do it, it's more or less on the same line, you see, or it should be all like this. I don't know. So you just make your own variation and see how it looks better for you, or look how it looks here and do it more like here. For example, this one, it's the nearest to the original. So let's do this one. So it's quite cool. And here this sort of O, it comes from this O, sort of from this element. Let's do it. Yeah, this is quite. And I think it's really cool.
Nice.
Looks interesting. So you can also just like add this thickness to it, just by adding another line. If your pen doesn't do this kind of very thick kind of lines, you can just add yourself.
Mm.
Yeah, you should just practice it. Well, let's do it again. Should be like that more. So. I don't know. Mine, they don't look so great either, but you just really need to practice. And the more you practice, the more easy to... Okay.
It's too much.
Sorry, it got hot.
It's here. I'm going to close the Instagram.
Okay.
And
I'll do just the whole kind of alphabet on one page.
Yes.
That's what I'm going to do.
I will put the link in the stories, so if you want to finish the session.
Because I think it's a very nice kind of exercise, and it will take longer than 1 hour. So, and I would not neglect this kind of this squiggles exercise, because it will give you a lot of confidence with your writing, because here your hand should be already steady and should be already kind of accustomed to making all these lines and these kind of things, squiggles. Yeah, let's go ahead with this alphabet, and I think it's quite interesting. So you can always do your own. So I can do alphabet, trying to replicate this one, and then I'll do it the way how I would do it myself, with just my handwriting. That's the plan. Not simple. Okay, bye-bye to Instagram. And we're still here on YouTube, so let's do... Yeah, it's much easier actually with this pen. So A, and then A, then B. Hey, this B is so ugly. Let's do another B. Again, very ugly B, but it's okay. Let's make another one. Sorry, Beatrice. But B, it's more challenging for me than F. And A, definitely. So Beatrice Bianco. Beautiful. So this B, it's much easier for me, the little one. C is definitely quite simple. So you can do it like this, you see. So, and I'll try to write it as well, because just a letter on its own, it's much more difficult probably to do than... and in the context. So G. No. G. Yeah. Not so bad, this one. Yeah. E, it's very easy for me, because this is the same E that I used to write in Russian as well. And can make it a bit bigger here, there, and F, we just did it. F, G. So just H. This is I, sorry. J. Okay. Okay. Oh, okay, like here. L. I like N, M and N. They look very, very cool. N, O, P, P, Q. R. R, it's like B. I don't know mine. Exactly the same. Exactly the same way I do it. I don't know. It's not my way of writing this R. R, S. So now when I finish this, I'll do it my way, because this is quite difficult to do the way how others write, because you really just like you're used to certain way of writing, and then let's do again as and I'm just like trying to copy from the book. Not my S. So that's why I would say try not to copy, but try to make your own kind of handwriting in the calligraphic way. So maybe it will be much easier for you, because otherwise you're just really breaking your brain. So, T. Of course, it's better to practice all these kind of things, and maybe some of these ideas will come quite naturally to you. But sometimes it's easier in first kind of step maybe to do it your own kind of way. And V. Doesn't come to so easily to me this X. The way how it's written here. Y. And Z. So, okay, this is, I copied here, now I'll do mine. That will be much, much easier for me, believe me, because now I was just like trying to think too hard to do it. And frankly speaking, with the fountain pen, it's much easier, that's what I would say. So let's do it just alphabet with my handwriting. So, okay. B, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, J. I think N, I write it differently. I write like this. So N, O, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z, X. Oh, I would also write like this, X. This is much easier for me.
I can see. Before you can see it, that it comes really natural to you.
And now, what do you want to... I can write something like practice mix. Mix it better, or what is it?
A little sentence, yeah.
Yeah, let's use some sentence. Practice. Is as much as possible. As you can. And result, you know, time. I think that's how I would write. This is my almost my normal normal writing. So for the invitations, I was doing a little bit of more this kind of squiggles and stuff. So you can also put here some kind of something like this. So just to make it more beautiful, but maybe not. But this kind of things you can also practice more, and the more you practice, it will come out much more beautiful. But it's quite important not to be stiff. Here, so it should be very, very fluent. So now let's go to the next kind of little part about making these little decorations. So, and okay, and yes, I'll probably do it just like for 10 minutes, and that's it. Yeah, Beatrice says that it's we shouldn't do it for long, and I agree, of course. So let's do it for the 10 minutes, yeah? So we can use just a normal pen for that. So I would use 0.5, maybe. So let's use 0.5. And here, of course, there is this paper plane. Where is my paper plane? So paper plane, you can do it in a different way. So the simple one is, if you do it just like this, so you should it's more or less like a triangle, and then like that. So then just goes directly there. So that's it, that's a paper plate, and then you can do just like some lines, or you can do, of course this paper plane will not do that, or you can do it more, with a bit of angle, so it's more or less the same, but with this sort of perspective. So this looks better, I would say, and you can always just connect this mentally like that, and it can go even like that, but or you can also just like do some kind of little hatching with some smaller, yeah, like this. So this is paper plane. I think that's cool. This is a simplified paper plane. Just do it like that. Much wider, I would say. And then just like this. That's it. This is paper plane as well, I think. Looks like a paper plane, I think. Was not necessary, but it's fine. So now let's do a diamond. Diamond is also quite popular shape. It's very simple, so you just make it trapeze, so like this, then make, for example, line dot here, so that you can connect it, so it should be in the middle of trapeze, and other two dots that you connect directly here, and then you can just like connect here, that. So this is your diamond. If you want to add sparkles, just make this nice little kind of lines. Then the idea, it's quite nice, this bulb, so you just make a sort of circle, so then it goes down. And then, if you want, this is the easiest way of making this spiral, and of course, that's it. So, if you want some smaller bulb, they also come in this shape. Again, just make it like this. Just some kind of, that's it. It's done. another kind of interesting shape is maybe the crown. So crowns can be of all different shapes and sizes, and you can make it as you want. If you made a little mistake like me, so you can just add additional kind of colors, no lines, and again it's just like okay. You can also make them like this, like rhombus, just like little more kind of cool. You can make it
more precious,
I don't know, whatever you want. So you can make it like that, can make it whatever you want. So so this is the crown, and sometimes it can become even with the hat.
balloon
is very easy. Yeah. I thought that it's easy. Balloon is just something like that, then something like this, and maybe just like this. If you want, yes, over here. If you want, You can write something here. So you can write I'm happy maybe. You can make balloons, for example, as your as your mood kind of tracker as well. So whatever you want, you can put some kind of balloon and write which mood you were today, or did you create something or whatever. So this kind of things, especially this in the light bulbs as well. So you can also make some faces or whatever. So next one, maybe we can make this like, so like hand. So you just make this sleeve first, then go up. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. So now that's it. I think it looks like a thumb. Doesn't look like a thumb, but like this. Let's do it again. So let's start from the thumb. Too thick. Now goes on 2, 3, 4. That's it. Looks like a thumb. letter, it's very easy. So you just make it just rectangular shape. Triangle on the top. On the bottom. So this is the simple letter. If you want, you can add this kind of lines with maybe thinner kind of, you can do the same. You don't need to do the same. So you can just add a bit of few lines to make it more kind of pop out. Then shall we make a camera? I think camera could be nice. So you just make again this shape of the rectangle, but a bit up on the top. So then just make this. And here, huge lens. Round shape. Maybe some other. Shape, and now color it. It's always easier to color in the shape than to color the opposite. I don't know who does it. So doesn't need to be colored in. You can only shade it like this as well. It also looks quite nice. So here you can put some kind of button. And if you want, you can also add a bit of details. So just some kind of little sort of belt. Your camera, so with some something like that. I think looks quite cute. You can always add a little bit of details if you want. And shall we add this ciabatta? I think it's cool. It's for the vacation.
Yeah.
I don't want to do the plain because it will be too much kind of detail, but you can also make it, of course, easy. So ciabatta is very easy, so you just make a shape of the sort of foot. So it's like two peanuts. Then put the slides and then double. Well, you can keep it simple like this. So I think the Click on inside here, sorry. So yeah. Look much better like that. Yeah. So I think it looks quite cool. And if you want, you can make some cherries. Cherries, very simple to make. I think it looks like a cheese body. Well, you can color it, of course. Of course, you can shade it or whatever you want. So it looks like a cherry body.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think that's it. So you can really just like make the whole page of all these things. I can also add a little bit of this kind of decorations if you want. Or the maybe some, yeah, it's something like that. Maybe some decorative kind
yeah,
of.
Yeah, more decorative. Yeah, we do.
No, let's do the sun. Sun, very very easy. Everybody knows how to do the sun. Then the. So this is the cloud. So it's very easy to do it with this kind of. Maybe like this. You can do it also like that. But I think this looks more like a cloud. Maybe not. No. Maybe. So with some shading it looks exactly like a cloud. And with these drops.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like rain. And for example, if you want to draw some kind of snowflakes, it's very, very easy as well. So just try to be creative and do it your own way as well. Make it slightly different from everybody else. Doesn't look like a snowflake, but who cares? Yep, looks quite cute, I think. Yep, this is my snowflake. And yeah, these decorative things we already showed you, so you can also see it from this page. So Beatrice can take photos of these kind of decorations. You can also just like do it yourself. So here I would say this is very simple if you are following my so something like that. So you can also start from this little wriggle as well. Something. There are very popular kind of arrows. They are very simple. And you can do it as simple as this to something more complex like this. And there are sometimes different kind of little things like that. I don't know. So just you can decorate it. You can make some kind of lines and so just do it as you wish, as complex as you want them to be. So. This is your kind of fast arrow that is going somewhere, I don't know, towards some goal. I don't know, maybe you can even make some kind of...
Mm-hmm. Again, for your mood, not for track, for your goals.
Yeah, so whatever you like. So you can can color them and whatever, do what you like. Maybe, yeah, just something like this, and then I can stop. Because, yeah, some kind of, yeah, we were doing something similar to this. So if you want, you can make a name of your month, for example, something like this. So you just need to make this line first, then go down, go back. So I just do it of the shape that you like, and here you do the similar kind of thing. So you can go down as well, or you can go up, like here, for example. So I don't know what I'm doing, but so I can just follow. It's important just to keep the same thickness. That's it. So, here as well, of course, this will be sort of in the shadow. And if you want, you can also add a bit of shadow. The bottom, some kind of frame detail, and so something like that, or some kind of symbols like this. Very, very easy, and you can always just get some kind of idea from here, but make it completely different by adding your own elements and with a little kind of just a liner pen, you can make whatever you really like. So some kind of date here, for example, and so for example, 5th, 5th, I don't know, 5, whatever. So this could be your corners of the these kind of corners. You can also make some kind of flowers, of course, so you can do some rose detail. Some berries if you want. You can do whatever you really like, and when you do it, try not to look very straight to what you're doing. Just try to make a blurry kind of look, and you'll not see the details, and it will be much free for you to do it. And just as a last kind of thing that I wanted to show you is just, you can also use this our metallic paints, for example, for decorating. So you can use you can draw everything with your pen, and then you can just add a bit of sparkle, for example. So add some gold to your sun. Can be completely out of your lines, but it will look quite cool, I think. so you also make your cloud, for example, more dramatic by adding more kind of color to it. So do something like that. Just really rain. Or if it's really cute cloud and more like a cloudy day but not so much sunny, maybe you can add just a little bit of blue around the cloud so it's not as heavy this cloud like here. So if you forgot your sun here, so you can add it. So like this. Can add the sun like this, and this way it's already very nice and cute. Your sun. Maybe yellow is better than this gold. Yeah. So this is what I wanted to show you, because at the end these colors are not so strong. They're more like pastel colors, and for journaling I would not suggest to use this strong kind of pure colors, but using this glimmering kind of colors of the metallic colors, they'll immediately add this kind of cuteness to it by shimmer and also by this more pastel-like color. So you can of course play with different kind of shades of colors, of course, so you can add a little bit more stronger kind of colors, but in a way it will look very, so you can really add a little bit of color, but not to not be overwhelming, you know, like if you'll be using just normal colors. And of course a little bit of purple, maybe blue, purple and blue immediately gives this cool effect, I think, to your illustrations. So and yeah, that's what I would suggest you. And also for the mood tracking, it would be really cool if you'll be adding the colors as well. So for happy, what is the color for happiness for you? So you can have some different happy as well. So for example, today it's much more kind of calm, like some sort of pink happy. It's not this explosive kind of I'm very happy. But it's like, oh yes, and I'm calm and happy, so you can also add little kind of shading with different type of pink, for example, and it's immediately very nice. So that's what I wanted to show you, and at the end I also want to add a bit of cherry and green. Look at that, immediately. Mm-hmm. Their life. And so if you like our lives, please put your thumbs up. Maybe that was not necessary. So this one. So you can always remove the some watercolor with paper, I don't know. Not with this paper, but with the tissue paper. I don't have tissue paper with me, but if you add a bit of water like this immediately, take a tissue paper, so I'm just using normal paper, it will absorb, you see, and you can add blue shirt, for example. Yeah. So if you really like our lives, please come again and join us. So have a lovely day, and See you next time. Bye.